بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. All praise and thanks belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May the peace and blessing of Allah be upon His servant and final messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. As to follows, my dear respected brothers in Islam, this is the first night of the 10 blessed nights of Ramadan. What I wanted to share with you is something in a few minutes, so we don't take too long. And that is the fact that this blessed month, Shahru Ramadan, has also been known as Shahru Sabr. Shahru al-Sabr, the month of patience. Wal ulama rahimahumullah, they tied between fasting and patience. This is what I'm going to spend the next few minutes in explaining to you. What is the connection between fasting and patience, and what can we learn from this in the days that are to come for us for these last 10 nights of Ramadan? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, my brothers in Islam, He says in the Quran, وَاسْتَعِينُوا بِالصَّبْرِ وَالصَّلَاةِ. Seek Allah's help through الصبر and الصلاه. الصبر here, العلماء رحمهم الله, they said, الصبر هو الصيام. الصبر is fasting. Therefore, Allah Azza wa Jalla is saying, وَاسْتَعِينُوا بِالصَّبْرِ وَالصَّلَاةِ. Seek Allah's help. Seek Allah's help for what? Seek Allah's help for everything that you're going to do in life through fasting and through salat. Through fasting and through salat. Therefore, ulama rahimahumullah, they said that there is a strong link and a connection between fasting and patience. What's the link between them? Let's see this. My brothers in Islam, when we speak about patience, patience is three categories. And when we say patience, all of a sudden, most people think about patience as what? And if someone swore at you, just be patient and don't swear back. If someone hits you, be patient and forgive him. If something happens of a disaster, just be patient. But this is what we think patience is. Patience is more than that. It's three categories. Number one, العلماء رحمهم الله, they say الصبر على طاعة الله, to remain patient upon the worship of Allah. Do you know getting up for Fajr every day needs patience? Or making wudu every salat needs patience if you lose it. And reading Quran throughout Ramadan and before and after Ramadan requires patience. And the effort that you're going to put in these last 10 nights require patience. And I tell you, this is the key to a successful Laylatul Qadr. Patience. Be patient with the worship. Wallah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Maryam, He says, فَاعْبُدْهُ وَاصْطَبِرْ لِعِبَادَتِهِ. Worship Him and remain patient over His worship. Don't give up. You see, the biggest calamity today when people lose their deen is summarized in one word. He gave up. That's the biggest calamity. He gave up. Brother had a past, then he made a tawbah. Walhamdulillah, he joined the congregation and he began to pray and steadfast upon the correct path. He went to Hajj, he came back a few years later, he's gone. He's gone, you don't see him anymore. Wala raka'ah, nothing in his life, no more salat. Why? He wasn't patient. He wasn't patient. Wastabir li'ibadati. Even this is the first category of patience, and it's the greatest of categories, to remain patient over the worship of Allah. طيب, how do we connect this to fasting? Because fasting, it's a worship. Fasting from Fajr to sunset is a worship. So you're supposed to remain patient upon this worship. طيب, that's the first category, and we linked it with fasting. The second category of patience, العلماء رحمهم الله, they say, الصبر عن المعصية, to remain patient when it comes to evil temptations and desires and sins. Your nafs wants you to commit the sin. According to this second category of patience, it means to be patient and don't do the sin. Delay the sin. You've had a long day, and then at futur you want to take the cigarette. You know, people have this urge that by futur time they need their cigarette. Be patient. Delay the sin. Be patient. Someone is, Allah Azza wa Jalla has tested him with haram in his home, in the middle of the night, by himself. Be patient. Be patient from the sins. Keep away from them. That requires patience. طيب, how does this tie in with Ramadan? In Ramadan, some things that are halal become haram. And you're supposed to remain patient because if you do them, it's a sin. Like eating and drinking and engaging in sexual activity with one's wife. فإذن, these are things that are permissible. لكن they become haram upon a fasting person during the day of Ramadan. So the second category, which is being patient from the sin, meaning these things will tempt you during the day, you keep away from them. You keep away from them. Either now, we have seen so far that patient fasting has entered in the two meanings of patience, and that is that you be patient over the worship of Allah by fasting, and you're patient away from the sin, and that is by not committing these things during the day. And the last category of patience, al-ulama rahimahumullah, they say, وَهُوَ الصَّبْرُ عَلَىٰ أَقْدَارِ اللَّهِ وَالْأَذَىٰ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. It is to be patient over the difficulties and hardships and worries and stress and whatever it is of life. The difficulties of life. You lost a job, you lost a business, you lost wealth, you lost a child, you lost whatever it is. You remain patient over these things. Any harm, any difficulty that occurs, you're supposed to be patient and seek Allah's reward. What will help you stay patient is that you're seeking Allah Azza wa Jalla's reward. طيب, and how does this tie in with the fasting? Beautiful. Al-ulama rahimahumullah, they say that the hunger that one feels during the day, that's a difficulty. And the thirst that one feels during the day is a difficulty. For that hunger and that thirst, a person is given rewarded for. Is given reward for. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions this in the Quran when he spoke about those who go out fi sabilillah, fi jihadin fi sabilillah. He said, ذَلِكَ بِأَنَّهُمْ لَا يُصِيبُهُمْ ظَمَأْ وَلَا نَصَبْ وَلَا مَخْمَصَةٌ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. At the end, he said, إِلَّا كُتِبَ لَهُمْ بِهِ عَمَلٌ صَالِحٌ. Allah Azza wa Jal, he spoke about people that were engaged in his worship. And he said, along this worship, any ظَمَأْ they experience, يعني any thirst they experience, ظَمَأٌ, وَلَا نَصَبْ, and any difficulty, any hardship they experience during the worship, وَلَا مَخْمَصَةَ الْمَخْمَصَةَ الْجُوعَ, and any hunger they experience, what happens? كُتِبَ لَهُمْ بِهِ عَمَلٌ صَالِحٌ. Allah Azza wa Jal registers and records that as a good deed for you. Shuf, subhanAllah, this is why fasting was referred to as patience, because it fits in all these three categories. طيب, now we need to understand, and I conclude with this, is that now we understand that the greatest thing we need in our life is patience. You all agree with this? You agree with me that we need patience? Surah Al-Asr in the Quran, it began with the word Al-Asr. What does Al-Asr mean? Yani brief translation, huh? Time. Al-Asr, on one of the opinions, it refers, yani everyone's Asr is different. From the day you live until the day you die, that's your Asr. He's got a Asr, you have a Asr, everyone's got a Asr. What's the last word of the surah? إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالْحَقِّ إِذَنْ الْعَصَر needs to be full of sabr. That's the connection between the beginning and the end of the surah. And if your Asr, if your life is not full of sabr, إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَفِي خُسْرٍ. The human being is in loss. You lose yourself. فإذن, we agree that we need sabr. Now let me conclude with you by one dua I share with you that you can continuously make, that is from the Quran, and since it's from the Quran, it's the best of dua. And wallahi, this is a dua that if it remains يعني, frequent on your tongue, bi-ithnillahi ta'ala, Allah Azza wa Jal grants you the sabr. What is this dua? And this is the dua of the righteous, and the dua, it's a Quran dua. For you can just imagine how many of the righteous made this dua. This dua is Allah Azza wa Jal teaching us to say, Rabbana, it comes in a story, Rabbana afrigh alayna sabran wa thabbit aqdamana wa ansurna ala alqawm alkafirin. Rabbana afrigh alayna sabran. We're concluding. I'm just going to share what the meaning of this dua is. Rabbana, we're asking our Rabb, our Lord. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says in the dua, in hadith al-sahih, Anyone who asks Allah through his name, Ar-Rabb, three times, the dua is accepted. Yani anyone who says, Ya Rabb, Ya Rabb, Ya Rabb, three times, illa stujiba lah. Allah Azza wa Jal immediately would answer his dua. And if you notice something, that all the dua of the Quran began with Rabb. Rabbana hablana min azwajina. Rabbi inni askantu min dhurriyati. Rabbana wa taqabbal dua. Right? It all begins with Rabb. Rabbi ghfirli wa li waliday. And so on. Rabbana afrigh alayna sabran. Afrigh, this is a bottle. If I was to open the bottle and pour what's in it, that this action here is called afrigh. It's called afrigh. And it only occurs when you're pouring something, not when you're throwing something down. It's got to be a fluid. So afrigh, we're asking, oh Allah, pour upon us. Then if you are standing in front of me and I opened this and I poured it on top of you, what happens? It will completely drench you. Every inch of your body is going to be completely drenched with water. So look at this eloquent dua. We're saying, oh our Lord, pour upon us, drench us. Afrigh alayna, alayna, upon us. And if something is coming upon you, meaning it's coming from above. So we're asking Allah to give us something special from above. What are we asking for? Afrigh alayna sabran. As-sabr is patience in all of its categories. Why? Because it came with a tanween at the end. Sabran. And if a word comes with a tanween at the end, its scope opens up. It's not limited to one thing. So this refers to the three categories of sabr. Like an-nakira tufidu al-umum. That when there's a tanween, it implies vastness in meaning. It opens up. So every kind of sabr. Now you know what this means? If Allah Azza wa Jal was to pour upon you sabr from above, you just imagine it's water coming above and it's coming on you, meaning you want sabr to come on your hands. So oh Allah, give me sabr in my hands that I keep away from the haram that the hand commits. And drench me with sabr that it covers my mouth and my tongue so that I can have patience to not say that which displeases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And give me sabr in my eyes so that I'd only see what pleases you and I keep away from that which displeases you. And give me sabr in my ears so that I only hear what pleases you and I keep away from that which displeases you. And give me sabr in my feet so that I walk to what pleases you, which is al-masajid, to come and pray al-congregation, al-jama'a ma'a al-muslimin. This requires sabr. It's not easy to come here every day and pray, right? And sabr also to keep you away from doing the haram with your feet, and sabr with your private part, that you only use it in that which is pleasing to Allah Azza wa Jal, and you keep away from that which displeases Allah. We need sabr, even in that we need sabr. For how beautiful is this dua, a comprehensive dua of the Quran. We're asking Allah Azza wa Jal to pour upon us from above. Yani we're acknowledging our weak position. We're acknowledging that we are nothing without Allah Azza wa Jal granting us sabr and granting us the patience and the help and the power and the ability to worship Him subhanahu wa ta'ala and to abstain and keep away from that which displeases Him. This is a dua. Hold on to bi-ithnillahi ta'ala. Continuously ask Allah Azza wa Jal and say, Rabbana afrigh alayna sabran wa tawaffana muslimin. And understand that your fasting is teaching you sabr. It's exactly what fasting is doing. It is teaching you a sabr. We understand that patient fasting, this is what it's teaching us. So at the end of the month, this is a 30-day training of how to keep yourself patient when it's upon the worship of Allah, how to keep yourself patient away from the sin, and how to keep yourself patient when you face the difficulties in life. And that is, yani, simulated in the example of one going through hunger and thirst and so on. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us patience. And we ask Him subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless our days and our nights. And we ask Him subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept our fasting and our salat. Innahu waliyu thalika wal qadiru alayhi. Wa sallallahu wa sallam wa baraka ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in.